I did the 23andMe spit test as one of the first people to ever do it. I had no idea what I was gonna get, but then I got my results and I thought, wow, this is really amazing.
I was really interested in seeing what my genome sequence looked like, so I sent mine off early on. And I think a lot of people would also love to see how their genomes tell them about themselves.
Anne strongly believes that each individual has the right to know his own genome.
Since I was a child, I have loved researching about my body. And in fourth grade, I did a report about junk food. And ever since then, I've been interested in nature and nurture and my environment and my DNA. When I saw the human genome being sequenced, I knew right away that there was something substantial to do with that. And when I got to know the healthcare industry and I realized how much consumers don't have a critical role in it, I knew that there was a combination of the consumers actually taking charge of their own healthcare, and they're going to do that through their genome. 23andMe was born out of the idea that the consumer can actually engage in their own health and actually drive a revolution where healthcare is no longer about this episodic visit to your physician once a year, but it's about the continuous engagement of you being proactive about your own healthcare and having a partnership with the medical world rather than just being solely reliant on it.
No, I think it's really fantastic that this company, 23andMe, has really taken genomic science into the general public and made it something that we're all talking about and that we all have access to.
If you know what you're at risk for, you can potentially take actions to prevent developing one of those conditions or to actually proactively manage your life.
When you sequence a genome, what you get is data about you. And to comb through all of that data looking for the important pieces takes a lot of computational power. The research in my lab is really focused on trying to understand how our genomes and our genes are controlled such that we use the right genes at the right time and we silence the ones that aren't supposed to be used. And in particular, the silencing processes that I study are all about silencing these viral-like sequences that exist within our genome and that might be contributing to diseases like ALS.
Frankly, the reason why I wake up every morning is because of the customer stories. And when I get a story about somebody who says, I have three small children, and because of you, I know I have BRCA, and I just, you know, was able to prevent developing breast cancer like all the other women in my family, I mean, it's heart-wrenching and it's beautiful.
I've just been impressed to see how Anne is really dedicated to the field, really dedicated to science, and to making a difference to the world.
Anne is, alongside with Sergey Brin, is a co-founder of the Breakthrough Prize in Life Sciences.
So the Breakthrough Prize is super exciting. It was really the ideas and the brains of Yuri Milner, where he had this vision of making scientists, great scientists, into celebrities.
The founders of the prize believe that intellectual achievements in our world are underappreciated. The brightest minds who pursue the biggest questions should be celebrated.
I think Anne's making a big difference in the world by doing something that no one has ever done before.
Anne is a very creative thinker and a leader who is paving the way in a developing area of consumer genomics.
When I think back on, you know, the last 9.5 years, it has not been easy, but it's incredibly rewarding because I think what we're doing makes a difference.